Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how we can build a home garden watering system using Shelly Uni. All items used in this video you can find on cealsob.com. I have put the link in the video description. So let's get started and do the unboxing of Shelly Uni. So the box has Shelly Uni and a detailed instruction manual. On Shelly Uni, one side we have colorful input wires and on other side we have black output wires. Now we will take a 12 volt power supply and using connector divide the power supply into positive and negative. The red wire is positive and orange wire is negative. Let's screw the wires into the connector. Now, using this white connector, we will connect red and black wire of Uni to red and orange wire of power supply. Let us power on Shelly Uni and pair it with Shelly app. The red blinking LED on Uni indicates that it's powered on and ready for pairing. The pairing process of Uni is same as any other Shelly device. Now we will need a soil moisture sensor for getting input of moisture in soil. The sensor comes with LM393 comparator circuit that will provide analog output. Let's connect the sensor probe with LM393 circuit using jumper wires. If we check the diagram in provided manual, figure 6 shows wiring for analog digital converter. Figure 1 and figure 2 shows wiring for 3.3 volt power supply, which we will use to power the soil moisture sensor. So, yellow wire of Uni will connect to VCC of moisture sensor. Green will connect to GND of sensor and white will connect to AO of sensor, which I think stands for analog output. Now let's do some configuration in the Shelly app. So first we need to go to settings and set ADC range to 12 volt because our soil moisture sensor max range is approximately 3 volt, which falls between 0 volt to 12 volt. Next, we need to go to ADC automation and set over ADC threshold to 2000 millivolt and under ADC threshold to 1700 millivolt. This threshold I found very suitable to detect if the soil has sufficient moisture. In your case, it might be different. We also need to set over ADC action to relay on and under ADC action to relay off. This configuration will allow us to turn on the water pump when there is not enough moisture in soil and to turn off the pump when there is sufficient moisture in soil after watering. Now let's create a scene to get notification when soil needs watering. For the scene to send us notification when soil needs watering, we will set the condition that when ADC voltage is more than 2 volt, we want notification to get triggered. So let's do the final testing. I will use iPhone for testing notification and Android phone for testing change in ADC voltage and change in output. We don't have unmoist soil, but we can simulate it by taking out moisture sensor out of soil. When sensor is inside moist soil, ADC voltage is less than 2 volt and there is no output. When we pull the sensor out of soil, ADC voltage spiked up above 2 volt, Uni 1 is turned on and we receive a notification. Again, when we push sensor inside soil, Uni 1 turned off and ADC voltage dropped below 2 volt. Let's again pull sensor out and see what happens. So we can see that our setup is working as expected. Let me remind you, things used in this video you can find on cealsob.com. The link is in the description. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. In the next video, we will make a more advanced gardening system, maybe without using Uni. So please subscribe for the updates. And thank you so much for watching the video.